Welcome to day three here in Daegu. After Mo Farah's superb silver last night for Great Britain, we now turn our attention to the golden girl, Jessica Ennis, event one of seven in the women's heptathlon, aiming to become the first British woman to successfully defend a global title. A magnificent win in Berlin. She's in superb form this season. Here we go then. She set a personal best in the 100 meter hurdles earlier this month. She's got Hailey's Fountain of the United States in lane number one. Louise Hazel of Great Britain goes into the Commonwealth champion. Watch out as well for Jennifer Oeser. She got the silver behind Jess Ennis. That's Louise Hazel in two and Hailey's Fountain in one. Now we're back looking at Jess Ennis. Here we go then, the start of her title defense. First heat, women's 100 meter hurdles, the heptathlon.
Set.
Safely away, Jessica Ennis's title defence is underway. She's leading at the moment. Hailey's Fountain going well on the inside. It's Ennis on the near side, Fountain on the right, and Zelinka of Canada coming back into this. Fountain's going to get there, I think, just ahead of Jessica Ennis. It looks fairly quick. 12.91 inside 13 seconds. It was pretty close between the American and the Briton. Zelinka came through pretty well as well. Hailey's Fountain, well, if she gets it right, she could be a threat to Jess Ennis. She got it 12.93. Ennis hit the second hurdle, but she managed to pick up well. She's so strong in this event. Not the perfect start, but she's safely underway.
Well, she was absolutely flying, but watch, she takes a big hit on the second hurdle. She was leading at that point, was Jess. The momentum that she gained from such a good start, she lost it there when she hit the second hurdle badly, hence she didn't come across the line first, but she does look a little bit tight for me. But these are first morning nerves. She'd have been delighted with Mo Farah's silver, but that puts maybe a little bit more pressure on Jessica Ennis now to deliver for the British team. But she is a championship performer, isn't she, Rob? She'll be happy to be safely over the 10 barriers with a decent time.
Certainly was. She came second there, 12.94, which is only a hundredth of a second slower than when she ran in Berlin en route to that first magnificent world title. So, safely underway, and we're managing to grab a quick word with her here in the early morning sunshine of Daegu. Our first chance to hear as well from Sonia McLaughlin today.
Well, Jess, it seems that they've decided to turn the temperature up for the women's heptathlon. How are you going to cope with these conditions?
Yeah, it's definitely different to what we were training with in Ulsan. It was raining all the time and quite cool. So, yeah, it's good. It's better than rain, so I'm happy.
You normally like to lay down a marker in this one of your strong suits, the hurdles. Little disappointed with that or not?
Yeah, I mean, I would have liked to run a bit quicker and to have won that, but I just had a couple of hurdles and it just slowed me down a bit, knocked me off my pace. But all in all, coming second, I'm not sure what the time was, but yeah, I'm quite happy.
Well, I can tell you it was 12.94. You're the overwhelming favourite for this, but when you see the likes of Hailey's Fountain there, are you confident that you can keep this together and defend this crown?
I hope so, yeah. I mean, I was coming into this knowing that it was going to be a challenge, and I still expect that, so it's going to be a tough competition, but I'm definitely going to give it my all.
Good for you.
Thanks. Cheers.
Well, she's up and running, but Hailey's Fountain could be a challenger. Season's best for the American. Jess Ennis, 12.94. Zelinka came through for third. Personal best for Louise Hazel. She was 14th 2 years ago, but she's grown immensely as an athlete, and she'll be delighted with that start, the other Briton in this race.
Well, let's take another look.
Down the list, good start from Louise Hazel, fifth place. 1,089, she set a personal best in that first round, in those hurdles. And going down the list, Margaret Simpson going well in ninth place. Good performance from her. Ninth place, and Dobrinska as well, tied with her. Good start. So a lot of the athletes there, after that first discipline on a wonderful sunny morning, are going to be looking at this heptathlon and thinking, yep, I've made a good start, and we're going to give Jessica Ennis a run for her money.
I think you're right. 1.74 meters, Jess Ennis, opening a high jump campaign here in Daegu. Thank you very much. Well, she is in good form, isn't she? She's having a wonderful 2011. someone so short in terms of the other heptathletes. She's got some severe bounces, our British number one. 1 meter and 74 at opening height. This is a first attempt at 1 meter and 77. Well, daylight between the bar and Jessica Ennis. Early heights, confidence boost, points on the board. Guaranteed points on the board. We'll see how high she can go today, but she is in super form, isn't she? And she set a personal best. Well, she went over a height of 1 meter 89, which scored a 1,093 points. If she can get anywhere near that, well, she's cooking on gas. Group A, this is a first attempt at 1 meter and 80. Cleared 1 meter 74, cleared 1 meter 77 first time. First up at 180. Oh, and it's off. Well, she knocked it off as her bottom just went over there. The high point wasn't there for Jess Ennis. Well within her capabilities, of course. And for your information, her biggest rival, Hylies Fountain, has gone clear at this height, but she's got two more attempts left. Second attempt at 1 meter and 80 in Group A of the heptathlon high jump. Well within her capabilities. Better. She'll be relieved with that. At the moment, all but one athlete in this Group A has gone over this 1 meter and 80 height. She doesn't want to be losing 30, 40, 50 or even more points in this second event of seven. But the world leader, well, she had a slight blip, but there's a scorecard. She got over 180. And a quick word with the coach, Tony Minicello, in the crowd. She is in wonderful form in 2011. Well, once again, just like the previous height, a first-time failure. She claps her hands with frustration. As Dean was just saying, it's all about getting the timing of the run-up right. Well, she doesn't look very happy at the moment, does Jessica Ennis? Attempt at 1 meter and 83. Fountain's clear, Dobrinska's clear. Jessica Ennis is clear. That's better. She's not looking the happiest this morning in this high jump competition, but I can tell you, going over 1 meter and 83, that'll boost her tally after the hurdles by 1,016 points. She has to get these early heights. Group A is flying along. But well done, Jessica Ennis. We had about 200 coming in on that day to support the British team. So, Jessica Ennis, first attempt at 1 meter and 86.
Yeah, you can tell there she's having problems with her run-up. Jess is always going to be able to jump around the 190 meter mark, but it's the run-up that normally catches these out. And I can tell you from personal experience, in my high jump competition, I used to take my run-up back up to 3 feet in the competition. The higher it goes, the harder you run. And we've heard from a few athletes here that it's a fast track. So Jess was certainly too close to that bar, and she'll be taking her run up back for the next attempt.
86. There may only be 10 or 20 points difference in terms of these heights when they go up through the high jump. But she'd love to bag the 1,054 points available on this height. Oh! She takes it down.
Again, I'd have to say it's the run-up. And Jess, you know, every time you go into a multi-events competition, you have your bare minimum marks and you have your maximum marks, which you'd really love to get. And 186, let me tell you, is a bare minimum. And she's put herself under pressure there, one attempt to go.
But Jessica Ennis, well, she'd love to get a season's best. She has her best this year of 191. Third and final attempt at 186 for the world number one. That is better, Miss Ennis. My heart was in my mouth, as I'm sure all the viewers at home at nearly 5 o'clock in the morning, Dean, were willing Jess Ennis over that.
Sorry, mate, let me just sit down again. I've just jumped higher than she has. Awesome, Jess Ennis. We all know she's a fantastic competitor. She's adjusting her run-up every single jump. She's attacking the bar a little bit more, and there you can clearly see she has definitely got 190. in her height.
Well, she had a smile. She's talking to the coach, Tony Minicello. Clear daylight there as well between the bar and Jessica's clearance. Maybe she caught a glimpse of the head coach, Charles Van Comeny, who we can see to our left sitting in the stands watching her. Well, he's a relieved man, isn't he? Well, Chernova of Russia. This is her third time attempt at 1.86 meters. Well, she's gone, Dean.
Yeah, Chernova is only 23. She's younger than Jess. She's 2008 Olympic bronze medalist. She's a danger woman. She's in form. She scored 6.773 this year. So the fact that Jess cleared that 1.86 is fantastic news. She can put a little bit of daylight between her and the Russian now.
She'll have just seen one of her main rivals, Skyut, not go over. Oh, the high point was there. The centre of gravity was over, but just took it off Dean.
She's got that. Don't worry about it. I'm telling you now. I don't want to give her the commentator's curse, but she's got that.
What does she have to do differently, Dean, in the next attempt to get it then?
All she needs to do is just be a little bit more active over the bar. Now she's starting to approach her maximum height. Anywhere around 189, that's what she would have put down on her scoreboard. She's getting there.
How many times now has she become into major championships and delivered under pressure? She did it about 5 minutes ago with a third time clearance. Here she goes. Oh my gosh. Dean, you were right. You called it. You said she had it and she nearly had it there, didn't she?
Well, again, it's her run up. She was just too close at that bar. You watch her. High point's okay, but she just takes it off on the way up. And as I said, the higher it goes, the harder you attack the bar and the more you have to take your run up back. But you know what? Jess has not got the prettiest scorecard at the moment. And whether you're Olympic champion, world champion, European champion, whatever, sometimes it's her hard day's work. And today it seems like it is. But she is an awesome competitor and I'm sure she'll get it.
Third attempt at 189. Very rarely have I seen Jessica Ennis ask the crowd for their support in a high jump competition. Come on, Jess. Oh, well, she couldn't get over 189. She thanks the crowd for their support, Dean. The clearance then at 186 gives her 1,054 points. She's still in the mix. Her main rivals seeming to be struggling with this height. Just Fountain left to possibly get over it. But Dean, will she be happy with that?
I don't think so. I think 186 would have been the absolute minimum she would have hoped for, but she's lost about 40 points. Not clearing that 189, and let me tell you, 40 points when you're talking about 6,500 doesn't seem a lot, but you can easily fit three people in there.
Yep, so this is it. Fountain's final attempt at 189. Will this women's high jump heptathlon group A finish at 186? Can anybody get over 189? This is the only athlete who can possibly do it. Well, after the hurdles, Fountain was leading with Ennis in second, and in the second event of seven, they're the two battling it out for the points already. Will this be the scenario that could possibly go through this whole two-day competition? Well, as she gets it, third time clearance. Well, Jessica Ennis, of course, is getting her stuff together. She'd have seen that clearance by Fountain. Well, she will continue in the competition. 1.89 meters, 1,093 points for the American. Add that to the 1,135 she got from the hurdles, and not surprisingly, the American is very pleased. High jump, and here's the standings after two of seven events. Hylise Fountain of the USA, 2,228 points. Jessica Ennis, slightly further behind with 2,187. And don't discount Chernova of Russia as well. And Jennifer Oeser of Germany. Two down. Five events to go. Shot put is up next for these athletes. Then they'll complete the first day with a 200 meters as we continue through. Louise Hazel in 16th. We've just done Lithuanian, a lot of points. So Jess Ennis, first throw in a third event. 14.61 meters, the personal best that she's set this year. Yeah. Nice speed and a nice throw, way over 14 metres. Well, she knows she's got a fight on her hand, as the girl from Sheffield. She wants to hold on to that gold medal. And she's responding like champions do. So important for Jess Ennis. She gives herself a clap. 14 metres and 67, a personal best in the first round. That will settle the defending champion down. Well, Jessica Ennis, that first round personal best throw. Well, that's half a metre better than in Berlin or in Barcelona. On those two occasions, she came away with the gold medal. Every centimetre counts. Well, it doesn't look like an improvement on her first round throw. She talks to coach Tony Minicello. What did I do right? What did I do wrong? These athletes, Dean, don't they take such encouragement from the nearest and dearest and their coaches, of course. 14.51, so slightly down on a 14.67. So 14 metres and 67. It was a wonderful opening throw for the defending champion. She needs this. Well, it looks like it's going to be around 14 and a half metres. She gives herself a little round of applause. Another event down for the Berlin gold medalist. And I know we've said it a lot between us these last couple of hours, but it's going to be a tough ask for her to defend a title. But you know what? She always delivers when it matters. And now she's back into the lead currently with that throw in the shot put. And there's your standings. Jessica Ennis back on top for the moment. 3,026 points. Not one of her strongest events, so that's a good move up by the Briton. Skyute in second. Dobrinska with those big throws of hers up into the bronze medal position at the moment. Well, Zelinka's dropped down the running order a little bit in 13th. She was up after the first two events. Margaret Simpson and Louise Hazel, well, she dropped a couple of places from the 16th she was in before that event. But she's still going well. That's the third of seven events, just one left for the heptathletes this evening, and that'll be the 200 metres, which incidentally, Jessica Ennis is very quick at.
Here's the quality.
Jess Ennis looking to defend her title, and she's looked in wonderful shape here.
Gets a good start, already closing up on Zelinka outside her. Karolina Tymińska is a quick athlete as well, but Jess Ennis running a really good bend. Tymińska, the blonde-haired athlete in lane two, maybe closest, with Chernova coming through, the Russian, who's mounting a real challenge to Ennis, but Ennis is keeping her form together. Chernova is only a stride or so behind, but Ennis wins it. Chernova second, in third place was Tymińska, and a winning time, 23.28, is very good from Jess Ennis. There was a strong headwind of 1.5 metres per second, which really slowed her down as she came into the straight, but it shows the sort of shape she's in, that she can go so close to that personal best of 23.11 in those sort of conditions, and Jess Ennis with that will be in the lead position overnight, exactly where she wants to be. But look at Louise Hazel on the inside, working really well. The Estonian on the outside is just beginning to tie up a little tiny bit. A really good run by Louise Hazel, coming through on the inside. Superb! She takes it, and takes it well, 24-26 into a minus 1.2 metre headwind. Well, I tell you what, the Commonwealth champion may have been lying in 18th place coming into this event, but I think that was a really, really good run.
Jess Ennis sits on top after a fine shot put in 200 metres. She leads Chernova by 151 points. Sonia caught up with Jess to talk about how she feels the day went.
How happy to be leading this event overnight?
Yeah, it was a shaky start. Hit too many hurdles and bruised at my knee, and then the high jump didn't go brilliant. But so happy that I brought some points back in the shot, and then the 200 is a good time. So, yeah, I'm happy to be back in the lead now.
because often you start so well, you're not used to actually having to chase effectively. How much has that been a change in your mindset today?
Yeah, it's been different, definitely. I came here knowing that it's going to be a tough challenge, and you know, that was proven today. So it's very close. I've got a lot of work to do tomorrow.
I guess the shot put's your new favourite event, is it? It's lifetime's best. Just when you needed it as well.
Yeah, I was so pleased with that. I just try to stay calm and relax. Often I get too head up in the shot put and want to throw really fast, so I just stayed relaxed and it came, so I was really pleased with that.
Certainly did. Good luck tomorrow, Jess.
Thank you.
Leading overnight. Question is she going to be able to hang on? Because she's going to come under a lot of pressure, notably, I think, from the Russian Tatyana Chernova. Now, Catherine Merry's been watching this throughout. Kath, how do you assess Jess's chances?
I think it's going to be one of the tightest heptathlon competitions in major championships. As you say, John, Jess has a 151-point lead overnight, but this is the athlete who is currently in third place. Hailey's Fountain of the USA. She started so well yesterday. Dropped down the running order after a poor shot put. What has the American got first thing on the second morning in the long jump?
Well, quite a lot is the answer, isn't it? That's not a bad way to start.
It looked a safe jump. She, as well as Chernova, has a very good second day. Oh, perfect on the board as well. The athletes in these early rounds, making sure the run-ups are marked right. Nice basic technique. Eyes down. A lot of athletes look for the board as they come in. Oh, she's got a personal best of 6 meters and 89. Tape, a bit of an injury problem with somebody, give me a little bit of a boost.
Well, in all honesty, I think these girls, certainly in the decathlon, you expect a little bit of tape, a little bit of tuba grip here and there, but Chernova, like you said, look at that. A massive long jumper, got a great javelin, and a 206 in the 800 later on as well, so very dangerous.
Well, we've just talked about how good she is at this event. Her second day is very strong, as is Hailey's Fountain of the USA. This is the athlete that really could push Jessica Ennis for gold in this event, way behind the board.
To say she played safe there is an understatement. That's a bit of tactics. Let's get a legitimate long jump in there and let's get some points on the board, isn't it, Dean?
I don't understand it. I never really played safe. I went for a jump in the first round, I went for a jump in the second and the third. The fact of the matter is, a safe
guy's that problem with the shoulder, with the way it's taped up, is she?
No, but in all honesty, these girls in the restroom, they know what's going on, but this is who we've got our eyes on right now.
Jessica Ennis, I wonder how she slept last night. There's coach Tony Minicello, glasses on, hat on, watching his girl hopefully start the second day and defend her world heptathlon title. Great speed.
Yeah, that's very, very okay for Jess. I think she's going to be looking to push up towards the 650 mark. I remember just before she came out here, she competed the UK champs. She did long jump was one of those events, but it did take her over three attempts to start pushing up towards the 640 mark. She's got 14 centimetres on the board. She tried to gain a few there. But remember, she's changed legs in the long jump. And even though it sounds like we're making excuses for her, we still needed to push on. But I know for a fact that if I had to change legs in the long jump, I wouldn't be jumping anywhere near as far as she has in 627.
Why did she do that, Dean? Why did she change her takeoff leg?
Well, she had a stress fracture. She missed an Olympics and obviously afraid that she didn't want to open it up again. And very animated Tony Minicello is a fantastic coach. He's an awesome guy. And they work well together.
I was just going to say about Tony Minicello, when you see him away from an athletic stadium, never stops talking, never stops joking. Here it's the real business end. You see the other side of the coin.
She's such a competitor. Oh,
that'll be 937 points for the German. Can Jessica Ennis increase the points when she comes up for her jump? But it's now Chernova. 6 meters and 38 in the first round. 969 points are definitely in the bank for the Russian. But if she can approach her 2011 form of 6 meters and 82, well, she'd bag herself over 1,100 points, and that would start the day off very well for the Russian. Such a super strong day. Really chopped a stride there. It was a big jump as well.
Now, if that gets the white flag, and it does, that is a pretty decent jump. She said she needs to go close to her personal best. I'm not sure where it's that far, but that is a big, big jump. Perfect on the board. Look at that, just 3 centimetres to spare. That's exactly what she's aiming for. And that chopper stride helps her free leg to come through, which helps her takeoff leg. So she spends less time on the board, stretches out there for the sand. Look at that. That sand is very, very soft. That's why all the long jumpers and the heptathletes can land sideways. 6.61, that's a fantastic jump for Chernova.
Well, that's 1,043 points for the Russian. Jessica Ennis has to respond. We knew before this long jump event that Chernova could possibly gain over 100 points on Jessica Ennis in this event. Tony Minicello, eyes poised. That's better, Jess Ennis. That is better. Whatever Tony Minicello, the coach, said to her after the first round, Jess has put into action. The white flag is raised. Well, she's got to keep in touch with the Russian. She has to keep in touch with the American.
What a response from Jess Ennis. We saw in the shot put yesterday, she pulled it out when she needed it. That was a great takeoff. She sped up into the board. That's a big, big jump and a big, big response for the reigning world champion. 6.51 and a personal best. That is fantastic.
Well, there's the current point standing after that jump. Jessica Ennis, 5,088 points, equaling her personal best there. That's why she's smiling. Chernova, well, as you can see, is still in second. This long jump competition not over yet, but Jessica Ennis responded in style. And that's what champions are made of. Overnight, weighed up the pros and cons of all these athletes. And this athlete, Chernova, potentially had a chance to gain over a 100-point lead on Jess Ennis if you look at personal best performances. She's not doing that at the moment. That is big. Oh, the 6.61 jump. It was big, but she'll get no points for it, so she'll finish the competition with a distance of 6 metres and 61, 1,043 points. And there's your 1-2-3 graphic with Chernova finished. Ennis still leading. Chernova still in the silver medal position. But Jessica Ennis now will be looking to iron out a few of those technical issues that Dean spoke about. Such great speed on the runway. She'll be looking to plant herself on that 20-centimetre board perfectly. And launch herself out. 33 points is the distance between her and Chernova at the moment. And she came into this competition this morning, remember, with a 151-point lead over the Russian. Well, I think it's fair to say the damage that we were predicting to be done to the Britain's lead hasn't happened.
Well, she was trying very, very hard on the run-up to try and stay relaxed. She leant back into the board. And I think sometimes the speed on the run-up is where Jess actually loses it. She is so fast, and the faster you go into that board, the harder it is to time the takeoff perfectly. But I have to say, that second round jump, the way she responded to Chernova, she did it in the shot put yesterday. She did it like a world champion, like a potential Olympic champion, if I do say so, here in the long jump as well. She's a fantastic competitor. This is the tightest competition we've seen her in. There we go. Personal best of 6.51 in the second round. Awesome competition.
An athlete, when you know you have to deliver, when you're in pole position, you have to come out and do big performances. And there's the scorecard for the reigning champion. All the points adding up to 5,088. She is in pole position. There's two events to go, but Jess Ennis is on course for possibly at the end of the 800 meters tonight, defending her world title in the heptathlon.
So much one suspects for Jess Ennis now revolves around the javelin, one of her weaker disciplines. In the shot, the other throwing discipline, she responded magnificently to the efforts of Hailes Fountain, who officially are the standings as we have them after the conclusion of the long jump. Still the javelin and the 800 meters to go. Jessica Ennis, where we want to see her, leading the way, but is she far enough ahead of Tatyana Chernova? Behind her, Hailes Fountain, looking down to the Olympic champion Natalia Dobrinska. Maybe that their chances have gone. It looks as though it's Ennis against Chernova. And further down the list, we can see Louise Hazel there, possibly on course for a lifetime best, currently in 13th position. Well, you talk about things which can be so, so key. This is the takeoff board. Remember Tatyana Chernova? This was her third attempt. If that had not been illegal, and it was illegal by fractions, that was probably a 6.75 long jump, and that could have made all the distance. Moments like that might be where gold.
I think Jess is going to go very, very close to a personal best. She's going to have to. You see it there. Chernova's taking the lead into the 800 metres. And, you know, we've got all the statisticians and the mathematicians downstairs working out the points at the moment.
I've been trying to do it in my head and I can't.
No, absolutely not. And even when I was competing, I had to have people doing it for me. And the fact of the matter is, you know, Tony Minicello, he'll be down there doing it all in the next couple of hours. Jess, she's just got to go away. She's got to feed herself. She's got to make sure that she comes out and she's absolutely ready. You know, she's not reigning world champion and a European champion for nothing. She is nails.
She is nails. That's what we want. Of course, there was a load of great finals last night.
Oeser of Germany at the moment back in third place. It's close for that third slot. And there's Louise Hazel back in 16th place. She goes in the second of these heats. Well, this is the first one. Tatyana Chua. There's the lineup. Jessica Ennis is going to be starting on the inside. And we understand that she's going to really go for broke, as you would expect from a real fighter of an athlete, the Sheffield girl. And if she's going to do this, she's going to have to go, well, not a great deal over 2 minutes. 2 minutes two, 2 minutes three, and then hope that she's in the region of 9 seconds ahead of Tatyana Chernova, who's got a personal best of 2 minutes 6.5, but a season's best only 2 minutes 10.62, and it's at the end of a long competition. There's Jess Ennis, so disappointed earlier on. If you're not with us through the night, if you're just joining us, Jessica Ennis in the javelin, just 39.95. That's what's given her problems. Astra Skyuti of Lithuania, the Olympic silver medalist in seventh place at the moment with 5.517. As Ennis, that's what she's done throughout the competition. High jump, not quite as good as she might have expected, but she's been up against an athlete right at the peak of her form. Tymińska there in lane three, seventh in the 2008 Olympics. She's a 2:05.800 runner. There's Natalia Dobrinska, the Ukrainian, currently lying in sixth place, originally a shot putter. And there in lane five, Hailes Fountain, the Olympic silver medalist, in fourth place, still with a chance of claiming bronze. 5:06.11 is her tally at the moment. And there's the current leader, the Russian, the Olympic bronze medalist. She's got 5,887 points. And if she can stay in contact with Ennis, then the gold will be hers. And completing the lineup, Jennifer Oeser is in lane seven, the world silver medalist. She's currently on 5,613 points. She's in the bronze medal position at present. And Antoinette Nana Djimou of France, the European indoor champion, she's fifth on 5,600. That completes your lineup. Well, Tymińska is going to carry this one out fast. Ennis is surely going to go with her, and it's a question what Chernova can do here. Look at that javelin, 52.95 she threw in comparison to the 39.95 for Ennis. There's Tony Minicello, the coach of Jess Ennis. He looks almost as nervous as she does. Well, perhaps more.
Jess is in an unusual situation, isn't she? But this is the time to deliver, Jess Ennis. You've done it before.
Well, there's only one way that she can do this. She's got to blast out and really go for it and run the risk, maybe, of blowing up on that second 400. If she's still got the speed and the strength endurance in her legs, then perhaps she can stay with it. And she has gone out fast, exactly as we would have expected. We expect Tymińska to be the athlete to go with her, but at the moment, it's Chernova, who's right up there in second place, but Ennis is going from the front. Now, take a look at that gap. 28.33 first 200 meters. No wonder she's established a gap over the rest, and if it's somewhere round about the minute point at the 400 meter point, then it could still be on. Chernova, who is in second place right now, she has run 206 in the past, but that gap is starting to widen. By the time it comes to the end of the race, it needs to be some 9 seconds. There's Dobrinsky, you're seeing the close-up of in fourth place, and there's the headshot for Jessica Ennis, coming round and taking the bell now, minute flat.
She's going through in proper 800 metre pace. This is what individual 800 metre runners go through in 59, 60 seconds. But Chernova very sensibly keeping Jessica Ennis in her sights, not letting that gap get too big. She's going to track her, but Chernova's looking like she's tiring a little bit to me. Come on, Jess Ennis.
Here's Tymińska coming through. This is the Polish athlete. Chernova is still in contention. Jess Ennis is giving it everything, but she can't respond. But she is going back now, Chernova. She's hit her own personal wall. Look at the Russian in third place. That gap is increasing. If Ennis can keep this one going, if she can hang on some way to Tymińska, you never know. But Chernova is digging deep and she's trying to hang on in there, and she's able to do so. And the Russian looks as though she's kicked again. She went through her own personal pain barrier, but she can see now that Ennis is not going any further away. Ennis is going to finish in second place here, and Chernova is closing on Ennis in third place, and Ennis is going to have to settle for the silver medal. Tymińska wins it. Ennis comes through in second, Chernova in third, and she knows, as she holds her hands aloft, as she crosses the line, that the Russian Tatyana Chernova has taken the gold medal, and despite such a gallant attempt, Jessica Ennis has had to settle for the silver.
She gave it absolutely everything. Coach Tony Minicello sticks his tongue out. We knew it was a hard ask for Jessica Ennis to put such a big gap on Chernova. She threw everything at it, didn't she, John? But it just wasn't enough. She will look back on those couple of events, the high jump in particular. Well, she did run a PB in that last event of 2:07.81, to Jessica Ennis, as did Tymińska, who won it, and a season's best for Chernova of 2:08.04. Well, nice smile and a nice hug between the gold and the silver medalists.
Well, you have to give a lot of credit to Tatyana Chernova, because she has performed superbly right the way through this event. 13.32 in the hurdles, high jump of 1:83, a shot put of 14:17, a very good 200 meter to of 23:50, good for her. Long jump 6:61, this was where she started to close on Ennis today. That was 6:61 as opposed to Ennis's 6:51, and then that 52.95 javelin throw compared with Ennis's little disaster of 39.95. And then in the final discipline, Ennis 2:07.81 for 9.97 points. She needed to close up more than around about 100, and Tatyana Chernova 9.93 was only 4 points behind her, and only fractions behind her in the race. She takes the gold and Ennis takes the silver.
Well, the home straight, the faces on all these athletes are very painful. You can see how much it means to them. Look at Chernova. She did pull Jess Ennis back down in the home straight. Such was the speed that Jess went out at. And there's a shot for you. Chernova knows she only had to be within a certain distance of the world champion to nick that title from her.
Jessica Ennis was bidding to become the first British athlete ever in the history of the World Championships to defend successfully the title that she'd won in the previous games. In her case, she took the gold in Berlin, but this time here in Daegu, she has to settle for silver. Hug of congratulations from the other athletes. That was Jennifer Oeser. She finished fourth there with 959 points, which, subject to confirmation, we think is good enough to have brought her. And here is the confirmed result. Chernova wins it in 6,880 points. Ennis second, 6,551. And the bronze medal goes to the German, Jennifer Oeser, with 6,572, just ahead of Tymińska, who had that terrific 800 metres, who took her fourth, and Dobrinska back in fifth. So there's the confirmed result. Tymińska winning in 205.21. Terrific effort from her, which hauled her right up the standings. But it's all about this woman who ultimately took the gold, Tatyana Chernova. And there's the happy smile of Jess Ennis. Maybe the Olympics will be her year. It was her year in Berlin. Here she has to settle for silver. Maybe next year, let's keep fingers crossed that she could strike gold. That is the smile that you'll see in your newspapers, I'm sure, tomorrow morning. Jessica Ennis, despite the disappointment, a valiant effort in that last 800. She couldn't quite get there. And there's Louise Hazel, and well done to her. She had an excellent performance herself. And here you are then, Chernova winning the gold medal, 6,880. Ennis, the silver on this occasion, not quite enough. And Jennifer Oeser of Germany taking the bronze.
Too much.
Yeah.
You know what? She gave it her best shot. Yeah. Just massive respect to her. Quality athlete.
Michael?
Yeah,
hats off, really.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think, you know, this makes it really dangerous for those girls next year, because Jess is a tough competitor. She'll be hard on herself. She'll really regret that javelin, and she'll go home and she'll work on it. And I think she knows that she can improve in some other areas, too. I think she can run a faster 200 meters, which is going to get her more points as well. So I think that she'll be in good shape for next year, but it'll be obviously a disappointment from today.
Yeah, I mean, you can't take anything away from Tatyana Chernova. I mean, she's just done 6.880, which is electric.
Yeah, I mean, it was an incredible performance. And, you know, over the 2 days, I mean, she was always in there. But I really didn't expect, to be honest, that she was going to be the one that would do it, really challenge Jess. I thought Hailee's Fountain might challenge, and obviously she didn't finish the 800 meters and dropped off a little bit today. It was a good performance over the day. It was very competitive, good to watch.
Should just say that Louise Hazel came 15th overall, so I think she'll be pretty pleased as well. Andy, I assume now you've had a chance to watch your race back. What did you think? Jessica Ennis coming over to speak to Sonia. Well, she's still waving the old flag at the moment. And Jess is now with Sonia.
Well, Jess, it's a silver medal. Many congratulations. You're still smiling, but I wonder if that masks a little bit of disappointment.
If I'm honest, yeah, of course. I came here to win the gold medal, and it started off poor, and I really got it together, and unfortunately, the javelin was a big disaster for me. But to win a silver medal, it's still a World Championships, and if I had to do it anywhere, it's here, because next year is where I want the gold. So, yeah.
You gave it your absolute everything in that 800 metres. Did you really believe that you could put enough clear water between you and Tatyana Chernova?
I knew it was going to be very, very difficult. I think it was about 8 seconds I had to beat her by. So I was being realistic, but I had to give it everything. I couldn't, you know, go half-heartedly. I needed to run as hard as I could and leave everything on the track. And that's what I did, and it got me a silver medal. So that's all I could have done today.
So do you now have to go away, sit down with coach Tony Milincello and work out how you're going to find that crucial extra distance in the javelin?
I think we'll go away, we'll analyse it. We're not going to over-analyse it. You know, my events are solid, I had good performances. The javelin let me down. It's an event which I'm normally okay at, and, you know, it's poor today. But I don't think it's something that's going to happen often. I'm going to go away, work even harder.
Congratulations, you're a world silver medalist.
Thank you.
She's one of Team GB's biggest Olympic medal hopes, but for now at least, Jessica Ennis is second best. Today, she failed to retain her heptathlon title at the World Athletics Championship in South Korea. And as our sports editor David Bond reports, it could turn out to be a blow to Britain's big ideas for London 2012.
Even here in Daegu, Jessica Ennis's profile seems to be on the rise. For the poster girl of London 2012, these World Championships were supposed to be a formality. Another step on the road to Olympic gold next summer.
This could decide the gold medal.
But it didn't work out that way. Having failed to build up a big enough lead on day one, Ennis produced a poor performance in the javelin, throwing way short of her best. That gave Tatyana Chernova a huge lead going into the 800 metres. Ennis needed to beat the Russian by 9 seconds to win gold. Despite a brave run, Ennis had to settle for silver.
Yeah, I'm not going to beat myself up too much. It was, you know, strong performances. It was just one event that, unfortunately, I performed very poor in it, and Chernova performed really, really strong in it, and that was obviously enough for her to take the gold medal.
For Ennis, didn't take too long to put her disappointment behind her. With the pressure mounting on track and field ahead of London 2012, Britain's team will hope they are left with something to smile about at the end of these championships. David Bond, BBC News, Daegu.
Let's look at sport. You've probably heard now that Jess Ennis at the heptathlon in the World Championship Games in South Korea didn't, I'm afraid, quite do it.
No, Jess was trying to become the British athlete ever, the first one ever to defend a World Championship title. She went into the final discipline, the 800 metres, needing to beat the first-place Russian by 9 seconds, and despite a brave run from the front, she couldn't manage it. She finished second overall. Afterwards, our colleagues from BBC Sport caught up with her.
Mixed emotions. Obviously, I really want to win that gold medal, but the javelin let me down. And, you know, I settled for silver medal, and that's not too bad at the end of the day.
Three PBs in there. It's better than the Berlin haul. You've got to take some positives to help that.
Yeah, I'm not going to beat myself up too much. It was, you know, strong performances. It was just one event that, unfortunately, I performed very poor in it, and Chernova performed really, really strong in it, and that was obviously enough for her to take the gold medal.
We should say silver's absolutely incredible, but I know Jess will have been going for gold. So too does the javelin coach, Mick Hill. Did it let her down?
That's it. I feel like the bad guy here, the javelin coach.
I
don't think so. I think Tatyana Chernova, the girl who threw in the pool before Jess, threw 52 metres. It was sensational, and that meant Jess had to throw a lifetime best. And I think, you know, I was sat at home last night with probably like a lot of people in Yorkshire watching, and I think she just tried too hard. She was going too fast, she was getting too close to the line and bailed out. I mean, she threw 45 metres warming up, apparently.
There is that weight of expectation on Jess, isn't there? Do you think we're all sort of, because we expect her to do well, that she feels that pressure?
Well, I think we expect her to do well because she always does well.
And she's brilliant.
And she is brilliant, and that was the first time that she's probably not pulled it out of the bag. And, you know, I was as surprised as anyone because I was out in Korea for 10 days and she was in magnificent shape.
But the thing is that she's seemed unbeatable for so long. These athletes are not robots, are they? I mean, look at Usain Bolt and his false start, you know.
Exactly. I mean, that's why we love sport.
They're people.
Yeah.
In a way, though, does it help her refocus, do you think? She'll think about this and sort of re-energise herself.
I think undoubtedly now she knows there are girls out there. We knew there were girls out there that could beat her, but usually these girls fall by the wayside and just, you know, has a party. And, you know, after the first two events, she's usually that far ahead that she can just enjoy it.
I mean, we should say, Mick, that she actually came second with 20 points more than when she won gold last time.
And so we've got to celebrate that. But then if she'd have thrown the 46 she threw in Barcelona last year, then obviously she would have been fighting for the gold with a very good chance. So, you know, it's disappointing, but it is a fabulous achievement, and she is in awesome shape. She's not injured or anything, so I think she'll come back a stronger athlete and we'll get stuck into it in the winter.
And we blame you, not just, by the way, Rick. No, we don't.
Does she blame you?
Well, I hope not.
Thanks very much for coming
in. Thanks a lot.
My pleasure.
Thank you.